feel the waves cut through me, hypnotized by the sounds I'm breathing in. Hold tight.
Hi friends, in my previous video we have modified a 5 volt charger to get a 12 volt output, and we have also made a modification so that we can get an adjustable output. And in this video we will clear all your confusions, that if you have any problem or any doubt on making this modification, it will be clear in this video. And now from the beginning, let's start with this Chinese circuit board. This is a circuit board from a local mobile charger. We are not making any modification in this charger because this is a pure Chinese circuit and it has no optocoupler or an IC in it. So we will not make any modification, because making any modification in this circuit will be dangerous because it has no safety feature. So we are not making any modification in this charger circuit. On the second hand, we have this branded company mobile charger and it don't have any optocoupler in it, and we are not going to make any modification in it because making any modification in it will be more complicated. So we will not make any modification. If you still want to make any modification, then you have to download the data sheet of this IC from the internet, and in that data sheet you will see that in which pin you have to modify the register value so that you can get the variable out. So it will become more complicated and it will be risky because this IC is connected with AC supply. Any misconnection will damage this charger, so we are not going to make any modification with this charger. And finally, we have a charger that has an optocoupler on it, and we can modify this charger to get adjustable output voltage or 12 volt output. For making any modification, we have to find a Zener diode. We are seeing that it has 3 Zener diode, but we have to change particularly only 1 Zener diode. That Zener diode must be connected with an optocoupler. So this is the particular Zener diode that is directly connected with a resistor with this optocoupler. So we have to change this Zener diode and replace with 11.1 volt or 11 volt. After replacing this Zener diode, we have to change this output capacitor. The output capacitor is 10 volt. So we have to change this capacitor to 25 volt 470 UF or 220 UF. We cannot use this capacitor for getting 12 volt output. In that case, this capacitor can blast. So we have to change this capacitor value from 10 volt to 25 volt. You can use 25 volt, 220 UF or 470 UF capacitor both. And for getting high output, we need high input current also. So for that, we have to change this capacitor also. Here inbuilt, it has 400 volt 4.7 UF. So in the place of 4.7 UF, you have to replace with 10 UF capacitor. By changing these three components, we can modify this charger from 5 volt to 12 volt output. And the most important thing is that when we are increasing the output voltage, the output ampere of the circuit, that means the output current of the circuit, will be decreased. That means this charger circuit is 5 volt 500 milliampere. On increasing 12 volt, the output current will be 250 milliampere. So for getting high ampere, we must make any modification on a 2 ampere or 1 ampere charger circuit. On 2 ampere 5 volt charger circuit, making modification to 12 volt, we will gain 1 ampere output on 12 volt. And on 1 ampere 5 volt charger circuit, making modification up to 12 volt, we will get up to 500 milliampere on 12 volt. And for making an adjustable output modification, we need a special component that's name is TL431. TL431 is a adjustable Zener diode. It has three pins that look like a transistor or an IC. Its first pin is reference pin, middle one is anode pin, and the last pin is cathode pin. So for making adjustable output, we have to replace the Jenner diode with this component TL431. If you want to modify this charger circuit to adjustable output, first we have to change this to capacitor, and after that we have to remove this Jenner diode and replace with this. The connection will be very easy. The first pin is anode pin and the last pin is cathode pin. So the first pin here is cathode pin and the last pin is anode pin. We have to remove this Jenner diode, and in the place of this Jenner diode we have to replace with this. The last pin is cathode pin, so we have to solder this last pin with here, and the middle pin will be soldered here, and this pin will be left out. And in this pin we have to solder a 2.2k resistor. The first end of the 2.2k resistor will be soldered to the first pin, that is reference pin of this TL431, and the another pin of 2.2k resistor is soldered to the ground pin. This will be the ground pin, and the other pin of this 2.2k resistor will be soldered to this ground pin. And after that we need a 10k potential, or you can use a 10k preset also. And we have to take out these two wires, and one wire is directly connected with the output positive supply, and the another wire is directly connected to this first pin. So all through the connection is very simple. So suppose this is our circuit and we have to modify, then we have to insert this TL431 like this, so that this is the cathode and this is the anode, and this will be soldered like this, cathode and anode, and the first pin will be connected with 2.2k resistor, and the other side of the 2.2k resistor is directly soldered to the negative output. And after that a 10k potential is needed for making adjustments. So two wires that is coming out from this 10k potential, first pin is connected with directly positive output, and the middle that is directly connected with this first pin. The circuit diagram of this circuit is given in my previous video, you can check it out. And so this is all for today. Thanks for watching.